beloved blessed people, that they will fulfill. However much it tarries, that day indeed will fulfill. I now want to switch gears a little bit and handle a very important sub-segment. A segment within the days of Noah, but now on the character of the person of Noah. Precious beloved, you have seen unto yourself, you have seen for yourselves right now, thus far, until now, that it's a privilege to listen to this message. Absolute privilege, because this is the message of repentance, this is the message of return to righteousness, this is the message of return to the Lord in holiness. This is the message of prepare the way for the day of the Lord, for the coming of the kingdom of God, for the coming of the Messiah. And this agenda is largely lacking in the churches out there, beloved people. And that's why I say it's a tremendous privilege even to bring this unto you. Now, in our stepwise understanding of the days of Noah and the instruction that Jesus gave, when you look at my Bible, in my Bible, these words of Matthew 24, 37 to 38, even 39, Luke 17, 26 to 27, they are all in red. And that tells you very clearly, it clearly tells you that these were the words of Jesus himself. This was the instruction of the owner of the church, the Redeemer himself, the owner of the covenant of God himself, the owner of the covenant of salvation, the beholder, he that brought it and unveiled it. This was his instruction to the church. That's why they bring gravity to the church. What a beautiful Friday afternoon, beloved people, that we can bask in the glory of the word. The word about righteousness. The word about repenting and turning away from sin. The word about the church to return to holiness. What a beautiful day, beloved people. Now I want to look at the person of Noah. The character of Noah. Who was Noah? I want to refer you, make reference again, back to the book of Genesis, chapter 6, verse 5. That you may understand why I am going back to Noah. That you may understand why the Lord referenced the church. He referenced the church back to Noah. Genesis chapter 6, verse 8. All of the above, verse 1 up to verse 7, talks about tremendous heedlessness. God is lamenting why he created man. Man is wicked to the core of his heart. Within that backdrop, within that surrounding, within that environment, then you have verse 8. He says, but Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord. It is one thing to find favor in the time when many people have favor with the Lord, but it is totally another thing altogether to find favor in the eyes of the Lord at a time when none beholds favor, none has favor with the Lord. It talks about the difficulty of the moment. Again, I say, it is one thing to find favor in the eyes of the Lord, at a time when many people are favored in the eyes of the Lord. But it's totally another thing altogether to find favor in the eyes of the Lord at a time when everybody has no favor with the Lord, their wickedness. So verse 8, within the backdrop of tremendous pandemic, a global pandemic, epidemic of global level, a global pandemic of wickedness and evil, then he says, but Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord. This is the account of Noah, verse 9. Noah was a righteous man, blameless among the people of his generation, of his time, and he walked with God. That is where I want to begin from, beloved people. So we see that the characteristic of Noah's generation, evil, violence, corruption, disobedience, animosity, I mentioned them. I enumerated all of them to you. They were people that chose wrong instead of right. They are people that disregarded God's long-suffering. A difficult time, beloved people. There was an explosion of sin. That was the environment. So can we look at the character of Noah, the identity of Noah, that the church may borrow from Noah? Number one, Noah was a righteous man, as we have seen. Number two, Noah was blameless, meaning he was very careful unto what he did. He never ever wanted anyone to rise up and point a finger at him and say, the other day you did this. Why do you claim to be holy now? Noah was, number one, righteous, a righteous man. Noah was a blameless man. The characteristics I'm reading, beloved people, these are the characteristics that the church of Christ today ought to wear and behold in these 120 years of God's long-suffering before the coming of the Messiah. A righteous church. Noah was a righteous man. Is today's church righteous? Noah was blameless. Is today's pastor blameless? Is today's Christian blameless? Is today's believer blameless? Number three, Noah was an upright man. An upright man. Number four, Noah was a holy man. Number five, Noah walked with God. In other words, he was in the pedigree of Enoch. Genesis chapter 5, verses 21 to 24. Number six, Noah pleased God. Is the present day church walking with God? Okay, I know now in Kenya there is a mighty phenomenon here. When I lifted up my left prophetic hand on the 19th of November, 2017, and spoke into the church, Sunday's church services, when I had just returned from the throne room of God in heaven, and the Lord had placed, he plucked the leaves from the tree of life and placed on my left prophetic hand. And then he showed me the fruit of the healing that would come once I decree, strictly based on the words of my tongue, the tremendous healing anointing to visit the churches all the way to Finland. So I know that some of you and most of you are now in a position where you can say, this church is now walking with God, because the physical hand, literally physical hand, physically touched people. And there's a big phenomenon going here. And the Lord is saying, yes, it is possible. every church, every nation can now have this kind of relationship with God, walk with God. Number one, Noah was a righteous man. Number two, a blameless man. And these are the characteristics of the church. If I were you, Noah, now, I would replace with the church. And this is a challenge to the Kenyan church also. That you may make sure that you don't squander the privilege the Lord has opened here to visit you people, physically touching people. Number one, Noah was a righteous man. Number two, a blameless man. Number three, an upright man. Number four, a holy man. Number five, he walked with God. And I said under that is Enoch and Genesis chapter 5, verses 21 to 24. Enoch also walked with God and did not see death. So in other words, Noah and Enoch have the same pedigree. But that's amazing because when you read the lineage of Noah, he's in the same lineage, same as Methuselah and Enoch. How powerful. So for those of you who are seeking family salvation, look at that now. All the way from Noah, coming to Methuselah, Enoch, and all this. Look at that. That is your promise right there for family salvation, family deliverance. In the vision of the Lord, when the Lord showed me on January 15th, the year 2017, this year, when he took me into the sky next to the big cloud of his glory, to the door to heaven, and I saw the church walking the straight way, the narrow way, single file, entering heaven, the glorious steps, the glory opened, and glorious steps appear, very, very glorious, radiant. As they walked in, I saw some of them with their children and wives holding hands and walking in, beloved people. Noah, this is amazing, with his entire family here. Number six, he pleased God. Noah pleased God. Number seven, Noah was a man that was faithful to God, a faithful man to God. Noah was faithful to God. Noah observed total godliness. Noah was absolutely and totally obedient to God. Genesis chapter 6, verse 22 attests, testifies to that obedience. The obedience that Noah exuded that became exemplary, beloved people. Exemplary obedience that the Lord Jesus himself had to point the church to Noah. Genesis chapter 6 verse 22, the exemplary obedience of Noah, he says, Noah did everything just as God commanded him. How awesome, beloved people. Exemplary obedience. How beautiful, precious people. Noah did everything just as God Almighty had commanded him. He didn't do 10%, 90%. He obeyed 100%. And if there is 1,000%, you put it there. Number 10, Noah was a strong man. Noah had the strength of the Lord. That's why he was able to accomplish the building for all those years. But you too as a church, that strength is available, beloved people. You have more access to that strength now, probably, than Noah did, because of the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Number 11, Noah loved God with all his heart, his soul, his mind, and his total being. Noah loved God with all his heart, his soul, his mind, and his total being. Number 12, Noah was totally patient. He had a unique and astounding patience. The patience of God himself was imparted on him. Is this church patient? You go to a country, you tell them the Messiah is coming, you give the message of preparing the way, they return to righteousness, you leave that country, they have quickly gone back to their gospel of immorality and prosperity. This generation is the Twitter, because the Twitter, the Twitter generation, the Facebook generation, the WhatsApp generation, the LinkedIn generation, the instant generation, instant food, instant noodles, instant popcorn, burgers. They don't have patience for processing. Process. Noah had patience, an astounding patience, the patience imparted by God himself. Noah was a very persistent man. He had a shocking persistence. 120 years building. He never gave up. Noah had the unshakable faith and belief in the promises of God. Within a faithless world, Noah had such a shocking endurance to scorn. He had a shocking, a monumental endurance, lacking ability. A monumental endurance to what? To scorn, to ridicule, to mockery, to blackmail, to slander. How many of you Christian believers today can withstand even just one simple comment from someone out there? Why do you wear this long skirt? Why do you dress like this? Me, I cannot dress like that. Why do you cover yourself like that? Why don't you dress different like everybody else? Why don't you be normal? Look now the way you dress. You look like people of the old time. Most of you, when you hear such comments, that is it. You call it quits. Noah had a monumental endurance to scorn, to ridicule, slander, mockery, blackmail, abuse, laughter. You can imagine the things Noah went through. He endured scorn, ridicule, mockery, blackmail, slander. Another characteristic of Noah, beloved people, is in the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 1, verses 3 to 4. 1 Chronicles chapter 1, 3 to 4. And these are the characteristics the church needs to cultivate, inculcate, and inbuild into their salvation so that they may be like Noah on that big day when God's promise finally gets fulfilled. When the Messiah comes. 1 Chronicles chapter 1, verses 3 to 4, it says, Enoch, Methuselah, Lamech, and Noah. The sons of Noah, it says Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Look at that. Noah was in the lineage of Enoch. That is what I meant. That you too can inherit the righteousness of the Lord and enter the family of God. Because Christ Jesus, the firstborn of the family of God, has already paid a surety for you now to be able to wear the righteousness of God. The next characteristic and the feature and identity of Noah is in the book of Hebrews, beloved people. The book of Hebrews chapter 11, verse 7. Another characteristic of Noah that the present-day believer needs to uphold, needs to exude, needs to show the world, needs to walk with, to walk in, to behold. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 7, it says, by faith Noah, when warned about things not yet seen, in holy fear built an ark to save his family. By faith he condemned the world and became an inheritor, a higher, he became higher, heir of the righteousness that comes from God by faith. So here he says, he's celebrating the shocking faithfulness of Noah, another characteristic of Noah. And he says, Noah is God-fearing, holy fear. Noah beheld the holy fear of God and built the ark. He's celebrating the faith of Noah in this verse, a very faithful man. He's celebrating here the holy fear of God that Noah beheld to build the ark, and the tremendous obedience that Noah beheld. Hey. And he's saying, number four, within this another item, Noah had zero tolerance to the wickedness of the world around him. Another point right there from verse 11, that when Noah had that zero tolerance to the sin and the evil and wickedness around him, he did not just sit back and say, look, I have zero tolerance, I cannot tolerate that sin. But he stood up and condemned it and rebuked it. Hey, how precious Noah! How beloved is Noah, precious people! How tremendous is Noah! He's raising the characteristics that the Lord, the spiritual characteristics the Lord wanted the church, his elect to bear in these days of Noah, in these 120 years of the grace of God, of Noah's grace period that we live in today. Hey, the 120 years of the grace of our Lord Jesus before the grace comes to an end. How shocking, beloved people. Another characteristic of Noah is in the book of Ezekiel chapter 14, verse 14. You can start verse 12, but 14:14 he says, even if these three men, Noah, Daniel, and Job, were in it, they could save only themselves by their righteousness, declares the sovereign Lord. What is he saying here about Noah? He's saying that while Noah was a righteous man, and while he entered into the earth, into the salvation that God had built, had constructed for mankind, the ark of Noah, that is the salvation, that wooden ark, that is the salvation God had constructed for mankind. While Noah entered with the entire of his family, seven of them to make eight, he says, Noah must have also been a good preacher, because he converted all his sons, their wife, and his entire family. And they too beheld the righteousness of God on their own accord, on their own merit. Because he says here, in Ezekiel 14:14, even if these three, Noah, Daniel, and Jacob, were in it. They could not save, they could save only themselves by their righteousness, declares the sovereign Lord. Meaning he told his family to walk God's righteous way, to walk in God's righteousness. He told it so well that they obeyed and they entered. And so Noah was such a preacher that it declared the entire world had been an obedient generation. All of them would have entered the salvation of the wooden ark that God in heaven had constructed for that generation. Today too, there is a salvation of the wood, the salvation of the cross that the Lord has constructed for humanity to save them on that day. Beloved people, have you beheld it? Beloved people, and if you have beheld its righteousness so well, have you well told it to your children and family? Have you told it well to humanity? Genesis chapter 6, I'm just reading this down on that. Genesis chapter 6, verse 18. Precious people, Genesis 6, 18. Tremendous days, wonderful time, blessed moments. Genesis 6, 18, beloved people. And he says, once I get it, I'll read it. He says, but I will establish my covenant with you and with, and again, but I will establish my covenant with you, and you will enter the ark. You and your sons and your wife and your sons' wives with you. How powerful that the covenant touched the entire family. How mighty that that covenant of the Lord reached his entire family, and they were saved on the righteousness they were taught and beheld by choice. Daniel chapter 2, 17 to 18. Turn with me to Daniel chapter 2, 17 to 18, beloved people. And it says, then Daniel returned to his house and explained the matter to his friends, Hananiah, Mishael, Azariah, and Azariah. And he says, he asked them to plead for mercy for God, the God of heaven, concerning this mystery, so that he and his friends might not be executed with the rest of the wise men of Babylon. Tremendous, beloved people. So, each one of them, on their respective righteousness, imputed unto them, credited to them by the Lord, based on the condition of their heart. Noah was an example to his generation, another character. Is the present day church an example to this generation? Your answer is probably going to be no. The abortion, the scandals of immorality, pastors with evangelists and what, and going same hotel rooms, what, you know, all the big scandal that is flashed globally. Openly done. The lie. Noah was a perfect example for his generation. Another characteristic. Noah warned his decaying generation. He warned his generation on decay, about decay. Say, be careful with this decay. Be careful with apostasy. Meaning, he was not in decay. For you to warn, you really are not, you must not have it. You cannot be a deliverer except that you yourself, you have been delivered. Can the present day church stand up really and say that she is the deliverer, she's going to deliver the this generation using the light of Christ she beholds? You have to be delivered first before you can be a deliverer. The Lord told the present church, you are the deliverer. You are the light of the world. You are the salt of the world. But what do you see today? You see that the present day church, when she went out, she was converted. She herself, when you see the way they walk in nudity, the sexual sin they exude, when you see all the things they do, then you know that this church is crying for a second Calvary. They are crying for a second deliverance. You cannot be a deliverer of your generation except that you yourself, you have been delivered. Noah preached repentance. Is the present day church preaching repentance? He said they hate it. They don't like it. They don't want to hear it. Another characteristic of Noah. This generation fears, the present day church, they fear, the present day church fears that repentance will downgrade them, will downgrade them. Repentance will humiliate them. You know, they are very proud. They have loftiness of their own. Another characteristic, Noah was a preacher of righteousness. 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 5 we read. Another characteristic, Genesis chapter 6 verse 5, beloved people. He says here, and the Lord saw how great man's wickedness on the earth had become, and that every inclination of the thoughts of their hearts was only evil all the time, continually in other words. The Lord was grieved that he had made man on the earth, and his heart was filled with pain and sadness. Verse 7, so the Lord says, I will wipe mankind whom I have created from the face of the earth, men and animals and creatures that move along, creep along the ground, and even the birds of the air, for I am grieved that I have made them. Verse 8 is an important characteristic I'm bringing to you, the church, another characteristic of Noah. But Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord. Noah had favor. That is characteristic, another characteristic of Noah. Noah had favor, beloved people. Favor with the Lord. Does the present day church enjoy favor with the Lord? I know that the church in Kenya, there is no doubt about it, those that follow this voice of the Lord, those that follow this messenger and the message of the Lord is propelling and trumpeting out, I know that the same, you have all the teachers of the church that is enjoying the favor of the Lord. But I'm asking the general church out there. Now, you see here, Genesis 6 verse 8, but Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord within the depth of the surrounding of wickedness. Can we then look at why? Why favor in the eyes of the Lord, beloved people? Why? Why did Noah find favor in the eyes of the Lord? This is what the Lord says. Matthew chapter 7 verse 16, by their fruit you will recognize them. Do people pick grapes from thorn bushes or pick figs from thistles? Likewise, every good tree bears good fruit, but a bad tree bears bad fruit. A good tree cannot bear bad fruit, and a bad tree cannot bear good fruit. Every tree that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. Thus, by their fruit, you will recognize them. Hey, what does he say here? What is he saying to the church? Noah had favor with God. Genesis chapter 6, verse 8 we have read. But when you read verse 9, it says, Noah was a righteous man and blameless in his generation. Meaning, Noah sowed the seed of righteousness. Noah sowed the seed of blamelessness. Noah sowed the good seed of obedience. Noah sowed the good seed of uprightness. Noah sowed the good seed of pleasing God. Noah sowed the good seed of faithfulness to God. Noah sowed the good seed of total godliness. Noah sowed the good seed of absolute persistence unto the task God had assigned him. Noah sowed the good seed of patience. Noah sowed the good seed of endurance to those, the mockers of God, those who ridicule God, those who blackmail God, those who abuse and laugh at God. He endured them. He did not give up and join them. Noah sowed the good seed of warning the decaying generation around him. And when he sowed those good seeds, Noah reaped the fruit of favor with God. So if the present day church wants to gain favor with God, this is what the Lord Jesus says to the church. Like it was during the days of Noah, so shall it be at the coming of the Messiah. So please endeavor to be like Noah. Because the 120 years of God's grace period of Noah are here now. And they are finite. They finish. They come to an end one day. Then sow these good seeds. Noah had favor with God, beloved people. And Noah sowed the seed of favor, means grace. Noah had grace from God. He had favor with God, meaning God gave him grace owing to what he did. Meaning there is personal will. I know that the person of the Holy Spirit has been sent to the church. But remember Exodus 16, when the Lord poured down manna from heaven. God is so capable, he would have taken enough manna according to what each tent requires, according to the number of people there, and he would have put for them in the tents exactly the amount of heavenly bread they needed. But the Lord wanted them to work out their salvation with fear and trembling before him. So he poured manna out there. And there is a portion, there is a part of the personal effort, personal will. You must have the will, personal will. You must have the personal effort, and then God will now help you. That's why I said, when I was talking about walking the straight way, that you must first have self-denial. pay the price of loneliness as you walk on that way. But when you enter that way, then you hear him saying, Matthew 11:29, that come unto me, surrender your yoke to me, my yoke is light, I give you rest. Then you see the Lord helping you. So Noah had to make effort, personal effort. Noah had favor with God. In other words, Noah had grace with God. Because he was a moral man. He was a just man. He was a lawful man. Righteous man. The book of Psalm 119 verse 172. He was a holy man. He was a faithful man, wholeheartedly and sincerely. He was a man of integrity. That integrity came from observing God's holy law, God's holy scriptures, God's holy ordinances, God's holy commands, God's holy commandments, God's holy truths. Noah was a repentant man. Hey. Noah was a teacher of righteousness, I just said that. What does that mean? Daniel chapter 12 verse 3. Noah was a teacher of righteousness, beloved people. Noah was a preacher of righteousness, a teacher of righteousness. And it says, Daniel chapter 12 verse 3, those who are wise will shine like the brightness of the heavens, and those who lead men to righteousness. In other words, those who are teachers of righteousness, teaching righteousness to people, will shine like the stars forever and ever. Meaning, under that theme, Noah was a teacher of righteousness. It simply means that Noah knew the difference between good and evil. Noah knew the difference between holy and unholy. Noah knew the difference between righteous and wicked. And when Noah knew the difference between good and evil, Noah chose good. He consciously and deliberately and intentionally chose to do only good. To be a preacher of righteousness also means that Noah walked the constricted way, the straight way, S-T-R-A-I-T, the constrained way, the narrow way that you see in the book of Matthew chapter 7, verses 13 and 14 that Jesus celebrates. In other words, Jesus was instructing the church to walk the narrow way, the narrow path, the straight path that Noah walked. To be a teacher of righteousness meant that Noah set the right, righteous example unto his generation. To be a teacher of righteousness, I repeat, means that Noah brought forth, he built forth in his lifestyle the exact, the correct, righteous example, the right, righteous example to his generation. To be a teacher of righteousness means that Noah did practice self-denial because the world around him was very evil. So he had to deny himself to walk with God. Another characteristic of Noah, Noah loved Yahweh, he loved God. Obedient of faith. Another one, Noah was very sad at the rampant pandemic, an epidemic of wickedness. Another characteristic of Noah that the church needs. Noah served the Lord all his time, all his life on the earth. He served the Lord Yahweh every second of his life. Begin with every microsecond of his life. Every nanosecond of his life. Every microsecond of his life. Every second of his life. Every hour of his minute of his life. Every hour of his life. Every day of his life. Every week of his life, every month of his life, every year of his life, from January 1 to January 1, Noah served the Lord all his time. Hey, Noah was a good husband because he and his wife, they served the Lord together. He managed to convince her to serve the vision of the Lord. Noah was a good father because his sons were converted. They entered the salvation of the Lord owing to his preaching to them. Noah rejected the world and the beauty of the material world around him. Noah rejected the world and the pomp and color and beauty of the material world around him, because the truth of the promises of God meant much more to Noah than the beauty of this world. Do you see that in the church? Hey. Noah had good habits. You can call it healthy habits. Because he had no clinical depression. Noah was not seeing a psychiatrist. Noah never consulted psychology saying, me, I just want to be happy. Me, I just want to be happy. No, Noah was a healthy man with his family. He must have been balancing his diet, eating well, because he had to do the earth for 120 years. And the Christians today will say, I feel depressed. This problem has come, I feel depressed. How then can you build the earth for the 120 years during the grace period of God before the door closes? Righteous, blameless, walking with God, obedient, faithful, reverence to God, worshipful to God, patient, held on the promises of God, rejected the world, rebuked sin. Noah's obedience